So in a previous episode, I showed you how to set up a simple Siri shortcut. Now you can do more complex ones using the Shortcuts app. Go to the Mac App Store once you have iOS 12 and look for the Shortcuts app from Apple. Once you get that, now you can actually build your own. But there's a middle ground. You can build your own, and you can see here you have two modes, Library and Gallery. In Library you can do Create Shortcut and build one from scratch. But you can also go to Gallery, and there are a ton of different ones that are pre-built. But just because they're pre-built doesn't mean they're not customizable. So for instance, let me show you an example. There's one called Home ETA. Let me tap that, and it gives me a description here. It talks about send a text message with how long it'll take to get home. Okay, great. And it says what it uses, and it has Get Shortcut and also Show Actions. Let's look at Show Actions here just to see what it is. So it gives you a list of what actions it's actually using. This is how you can learn how to use shortcuts, because you'll be able to build your own using these same building blocks. So here it's going to take a street address here, and it's going to get the travel time from the current location to the street address. And then it's going to send a text. Okay, so what happens when I hit Get Shortcut? You see, there are two points at which a shortcut accepts input. One is when you actually add it as a shortcut, and the other is when you use it. So I'm going to hit Get Shortcut, and immediately it's going to ask me for information. So I can use this. Let me put an address here. Coors Field and Denver, Colorado. And where do I want to send this? So let's just go and send this to one of my demo accounts. And it's added to the library. So now I can go to the library here, and I can see there's Home ETA. So I could now tap the three-dot button there, and there's a bunch of things I could see. I could see more detail here on all the pieces, and I could see how it's filled in. There's Coors Field, there's Denver, there's where it's sent. So now I know how to edit it if I want to. Now I can actually tap it here to run it, and it's going to come up with a result. So it's going to figure out how long it's going to take to get from my current location to, in this case, that address, which is Coors Field. Okay, so here you can see it pre-populates the message. So notice that so here you can see it's pre-populated the message. It's actually going to put the real address in there, not home. And it's going to tell me how long it's going to take to get there, and it's ready to send this message here. So this could be really handy if I'm meeting somebody at a certain place, or I regularly meet somebody, you know, at a regular lunch place or something. I could set this up to just text them how long it's going to take for me to be there, how long it's going to take for me to be home. So that's how you can very easily create this. Now, if I wanted to add this as a Siri shortcut, then I can go into Settings, and in Settings I can go to Siri, and in Settings, if I go to Siri here, you can see it's added it as a suggested shortcut. I can hit the plus button there, and now, just like I showed you in the previous video, I can record a phrase that I'm going to say to Siri, where it would automatically generate this. So using the gallery, function here, you can add all sorts of useful things. It's probably worth your time to get the most out of iOS 12 to actually look through all of these and read the descriptions and see which ones you can use, and then try them out and maybe add some as Siri shortcuts that you can you know, just speak whatever you want and it will say that. You could also customize this by going in here and changing the settings. And here you can customize what the icon looks like and the shortcut. You can add to Siri directly from here with that Add to Siri button, and you could have Show in Widget as well, and Show in Share Sheet. So that's when you go to share something, you know, so these actions that actually work on things like clipboard or, you know, what web page you're currently on, that kind of thing, you can actually hit that little box with the up arrow button to get there. So Show in Widget means that it's actually in the Shortcuts app widget. So I can actually swipe to the right here to bring up the widgets. And notice there it says shortcuts. And I've got shortcuts there, and there's that home ETA one I just added. So another way to activate these is from the widget here, as opposed to actually having to go into the app to activate it or having to speak to Siri. So in a future episode, I'll show you how to build a Siri shortcut from scratch.